In this video, I'm gonna show you how to mine crypto on an Apple Silicon Mac. It's extremely efficient and easy to use, but there are a few things you need to know before getting started. Hello everyone, this is Steven from Kumbara. Today I'm gonna use my daily MacBook Pro with M1 chip to mine some crypto, as Apple claims that M1 chips are super efficient in terms of energy consumption and performance. In this video, I'll focus on mining Solana, which is extremely popular nowadays. Before we start mining Solana, we need a crypto wallet, so I'll be using Exodus as a quick and easy solution. Go exodus.com and simply download the app for your Mac and install it. Then go to the settings and backup your wallet to securely use it. Create a password, confirm it, and save your 12-word secret recovery phrase and confirm it on the app. Alright, we are done setting up the wallet. Next step is to install the mining application quickly. Go to xmrig.com and download the app for M1 Mac. A quick info, if you use Intel, you can continue with the Intel application. Double click on the downloaded file and extract it. As you can see, we have three files in the folder. We are gonna edit these files, but just before we start mining, we need to find a mining pool that are useful for working together with other miners. This is the best option of mining if you are an individual who doesn't have a powerful machine for solo mining. In this video, I'll be using the pool unminable.com. You can simply go to the website and search for Solana and click on it. Since the XMRig application we just downloaded uses the random X algorithm, we need to choose random X from here. With this information on the screen, we will quickly edit the previous three files. Okay, go to the folder we just downloaded and right click on the config.json file and open it with text edit application. Scroll down and find the pools section. Replace the URL value with the address on the unminable.com website. Then here, type SOL and a colon here and paste your wallet address next to it. You can find your wallet address on the Exodus wallet app by searching for Solana and clicking on the receive button. Put a dot next to your wallet address in the config.json file and put a nickname. Save the file before quitting the text edit app. Go to the XMRig folder again and right click on the XMRig file and open it. If you get a warning says that unidentified developer blah blah, click on OK and go to the system preferences. Click on security and privacy and go to the general tab. You will see the same warning below. Click on open anyway and open the application. Okay, we are actively mining now. Here is some quick tips to use the script. You can see your hash rate value by pressing the letter H on your keyboard. To pause it, you can press P and with R you can resume mining. To check if we are connected to the pool correctly, you can simply paste your wallet address here. You will see your nickname and hash rate value here. To check the energy usage of your Mac lively, open a new terminal window by pressing Command N. Type sudo power matrix and press enter. Then terminal will ask your password. Type your password and press enter again. You can see power consumption of your Mac now. As you can see, the CPU of the M1 chip consumes 2.4 kilowatts. It's really efficient for the hash rate value we have. However, let's see the statistics and see how it's worthless to use M1 chip for CPU mining. To see your statistics, go to the Unminable website and click on Stats tab. As you can see, the threshold is 0.15 Solana. It means that you cannot withdraw your money until it reaches this value. In order to calculate the estimated revenue of this mining process, go back and put your hash rate value into the website. As you see, we are earning 0.01 Solana in a month. It's equivalent to $1. I bought my MacBook Pro for $1,500, so I need 125 years to earn this money with Solana mining under M1 CPU. Of course, this is not Apple's fault, but we are using CPU mining, which is way slower than the GPU mining. But I will test also GPU mining of M1 chip in an upcoming videos. So don't forget to subscribe to Kumbara and like the video. See you next week and hoşça kalın.